This fellow we've got here coming out spent years behind a mask, but he was not a bank robber, nor was he the Lone Ranger. But it was a showbiz gimmick. Today he is singing without the mask. His name is Orion, and he's a good-looking fellow. It's a shame that he had to cover that face up all those years. Would you welcome Orion?
Pounds of clay, and then he said, "Hey, listen, I'm gonna fix this old world today, because I know what's missing." Yeah, then he rolled his big sleeves up. Yes, and a brand new world began. He created a woman and a lots of loving, yeah, for a man.
Yes, he did.
Oh, yes, he did.
Yes, he did.
Oh, yes, he did.
Yes, he did.
He took 100 pounds of clay and made a life worth living. And Lord, thank him every day for every kiss you're giving. Of clay.
Yes, he did.
Oh, yes, he did.
Yes, he did.
Oh, yes, he did.
Yes, he did.
For short. Oh.
I've been called everything once.
Called you Oreo. Orion.
Well, I'm sitting in
real
good
name. Now, you are sitting, son. You are sitting in a place that men would pay thousands.
I ain't got thousands, but I'd pay what I got.
Huh? Your real name is Jimmy Ellis, isn't it?
That's correct.
Where are you from?
Little town called Orville, Alabama. Orville, Alabama. It's about 15 miles south of Selma, Alabama. I know you've heard of Selma, Alabama.
Yes, I certainly have. Why did you wear the mask, and how long did you wear it?
Well, I wore it... the reason I wore the mask was when I was with Sun Records, you know. Let's see, in 1978, I started with Sun Records, and my producer at the time, the owner and producer of Sun Records, decided that I should wear the mask, so he suggested pretty strongly that I wear the mask, and so I wore the mask.
A gimmick, a show business gimmick.
Right. And I wore it for about 5 years.
Did it work?
It worked for a length of time. You know, gimmicks only last a pretty short time.
Did people get so they wanted you to come out from behind the mask to see what you really looked like?
Yeah, all the time people wanted me to come out from the mask, and then when I took the mask off, they wanted me to put it back on.
Then the name itself, Orion, like a celestial group of stars. That's an interesting name. Did you select that?
The name came from, at the time that I signed with Sun Records, I had met a lady in Atlanta, Georgia, who had written a book, and the book was entitled Orion. And it was the story of a guy who became very big in the business, and then he became so big that he couldn't go anywhere or do anything. He didn't have any privacy. So he faked his own death and attended his own funeral as a pallbearer. And he had grown a beard and changed his hair color, and that's the way he escaped his imprisonment. Anyway, they did a lot of publicity on the book, and I give the book to Shelby Singleton, who was the president of Sun Records at the time, and he liked the idea, so we put the both of them together, and so that's the way we came out.
So Jimmy Ellis, with a handsome face, became Orion behind a mask.
That's it.
Okay.
That's about it.
We're going to take a little break here. It's nice to have you with us, Jimmy.